Okay, so let's draw the Earth here. Like that. And then let's put the equator on the picture as well. Now, we know that the Earth rotates in a nice counterclockwise direction, right? We also know, however, that the circumference of the Earth at the equator is different than the circumference of the Earth at 32 degrees north latitude or 90 degrees north latitude, latitude, not longitude. We know that as well. So at the equator, we know that the circumference of the Earth is about 24,000 miles. We know, however, that if you go up here to about 60 degrees north latitude, that the circumference of the Earth at that latitude is about 12,000 miles, so it's about half. If you go to the North Pole, of course, what's the circumference of the Earth? Zero. So we've got differences in distance on the planet. Equator, of course, circumference being the largest, and as you go to higher latitudes, then it gets smaller and smaller and smaller, and that makes perfect sense because we live on a sphere. We also know that the Earth makes one complete rotation in 24 hours. So the Earth makes one complete rotation in 24 hours. If you're standing here on the North Pole, you're spinning one time in 24 hours, right? If you're standing here on the equator, you're going once around the planet 24 hours. If I said, what is your velocity if you're on the equator? You could actually calculate that pretty easily. Because all the velocity is going to be is the distance you travel divided by time. So we know at the equator we're traveling 24,000 miles, and we're doing that in 24 hours. So we're looking at a clip of about 1,000 miles per hour, right? If you're at 60 degrees north or south latitude, the distance is half. And so now the velocity isn't 24,000 miles in 24 hours, it's 12,000 miles in 24 hours, which means you're moving at a clip of about 500 miles per hour. Now, by the way, there's not like differential rotation on the planet. The fact of the matter is, at 60 degrees north latitude, you are traveling literally over a shorter distance than if you're standing on the equator. So when we look at 500 miles an hour versus 1,000 miles an hour, it really is to an outside observer. It's some dude standing in space really far away, looking at you up here at 60 and looking at somebody else down there at zero. And according to them, the person who's at 60 is passing by them at about 500 miles an hour, whereas the person on the equator is traveling by them at about 1,000 miles an hour. So there's not differential rotation, it's all just from perspective, right? Okay, now here's the key, and here's the key to the Coriolis effect. Let's say that you're standing right here, and you're in Quito, Ecuador, which you know is right on the equator. And let's say that you've got a package that you want to send. And let's say that that package needs to be delivered up here to Nova Scotia, which we will say is approximately 60 degrees north latitude. Let's say that you've got a big slingshot, and this big slingshot has the capability of sending your package from Ecuador to Nova Scotia. So we want to send the package on the slingshot in that general direction. Okay, here's the thing. Let's say that it takes 1 hour for our package to go from Ecuador to Nova Scotia. 1 hour. Here's where it gets a little bit tricky. After 1 hour of time, this person on the equator is going to have traveled 1,000 miles to the east. Did everybody see that? Because remember, if you're standing here in the equator, you're ripping around the planet at 1,000 miles per hour. So after 1 hour, you have gone 1,000 miles. Make sense? If, however, you're in Nova Scotia, after 1 hour, you've gone 500 miles. Make sense? Because that's what your rotational rate is. Okay. Let's say then, for sake of argument, that we send our package from Quito, Ecuador to Nova Scotia. The package leaves Quito. Not only does it have a velocity going to the north, but it also has a velocity going to the east because of Earth's rotation. As a matter of fact, when you release that slingshot, and you release that package, not only is it going north, but it's also going east. So the true path that the package takes is this. And after 1 hour of time, the package is way over here. But after 1 hour of time, Nova Scotia is right there. So take a look at the path of the package took. It veered to the right, apparently, of initial motion. This is what the Coriolis is. It's not a force, it's an effect of Earth's rotation. That is, this dude didn't pick up this big package and say, I'm gonna throw it to the east with a ton of force. Absolutely not, he didn't do it at all. It's just the Earth's rotation. And so the Earth's rotation has taken the package to the east at 1,000 mile per hour clip. And it's taken up there it's taken Nova Scotia to the east, but only at 500 miles an hour. So if everything is left undone, this guy missed his destination to the right by 500 miles. That is the Coriolis effect. And we can play that same game in the southern hemisphere, in the northern hemisphere, anywhere on the planet, the results are going to be the same. Objects traveling in the northern hemisphere get veered to the right. Objects traveling in the southern hemisphere get veered to the left, always of initial motion. Coriolis does not exist at the equator. The Coriolis is zero at the equator. So let's draw this again. If you're standing at the equator, no Coriolis. If you're standing at the North or the South Pole, maximum Coriolis. It's absolutely max. Now, why is that the case? If you're standing here at the equator and you're moving with the planet, notice how far removed you are from the Earth's axis of rotation. That might not make sense, so let's take a look at the dude standing up here in the North Pole. Remember, the Earth is rotating counterclockwise. This person is directly on top of the Earth's axis of rotation, right? So as he stands on the Earth's axis of rotation, he is spinning a lot. He is twisting one complete twist in 24-hour period. But if you're standing here on the equator, you're not twisting at all. You're rotating with the planet, but there is no spin. There is no twist. And if there's no twist, there's no Coriolis. There is no apparent deflection of movement. So you maximize at the poles, you minimize at the equator. In addition to that, Coriolis increases when you increase the speed. So the faster the flow of air, the stronger the Coriolis effect will be.